make a way for us. Now boldly we approach, not by earthly confidence, it's only by your blood. It's your blood. And what can wash away our sins? What can make us whole again? It's nothing but the blood. It's nothing but the blood of Jesus. Oh, what can wash us pure as snow? Welcome as the friends of God. It's nothing but your blood. It's nothing but your blood, King Jesus. Oh, we praise you for the blood. God, we praise you for the blood. Oh, it's nothing but your blood. Nothing but your blood, King Jesus. God, we praise you for the blood.
Well, praise his holy name. Well, glory be to God. Well, it's offering time. Hallelujah. We're here to give unto the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, giving to the ministry, praise God, so he can take our seeds that we sow in love into the kingdom and cause us to reap of love in the kingdom. Why? Because we give because we love God and love people. Hallelujah. So that's why I tithe and that's why I give. Praise his holy name. Man, we're just so thankful that Jesus makes a way for us to be able to be blessed financially so we can give more to his kingdom to bless all over the world and our community. Praise his holy name. Man, don't forget that every fourth Sunday is Mission Sunday. And any month we have a fifth Sunday, it's Stretch Offering Sunday. So, man, just be praying, you know, to the Father and ask him to give you money to give into those times. It's only four times a year we have Stretch Offering, and then every month we have missions. But just remember, you know, John chapter 15 verse 7 says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, you can ask what you will and you shall receive it. So that's what I base my giving on. I ask him, you know, for extra money to send to me so that I can give extra into his kingdom. And I just believe that his word's true. And if I do what his word says, he'll do what his word says. Hallelujah. So don't be speaking things against you being able to give into his kingdom. If something arises and an offering happens and you can't give, say, well, praise God, Lord, I don't know what happened this time, but I'm just thankful that next time I'm going to have plenty enough money to give. And bind the devil from interfering with your money and your finances and command him to take his hands off of it, because that's more your responsibility than God's, because he's done gave me and you all the power to take care of that. So I bind the enemy from stopping the finances that belong to the people that will give into the kingdom and give to True Christian Fellowship. I command you to take your hands off the money that belongs to our church. And I thank you, Lord, the money's coming in to build our church and to buy a van for fellowships. Hallelujah. And for the teens and the other people to have it to drive so everybody can ride together. And I thank you, Lord, for it in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Well, don't forget, you know, just write on your envelope your full address, write on your envelope what place you want the money to go into. And there's three things that ain't on here in that stretch offering. So anytime you put in the stretch offering, you just write stretch on here somewhere. And anytime you put into the new church or building, just write new church. And anytime you put into the van, just write van on there. And we'll, you know, when we get new ones, we'll have that added on probably. But we're just thanking the Lord for taking care of every situation, every circumstance in our church, always coming through, and He always shows out. Hallelujah. So, Father, we just thank You right now. We praise You right now. We give You glory right now. We lift up our offerings to worship You from here, and we're thanking You that You're doing things above what we could even ask or think. And we give You all praise for meeting every need in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord Jesus. I'm so happy to be in Christ. Man, this is the first Wednesday of December. Man, we're already in December, the last month of 2020. Man, we're so thankful for what Jesus is doing in our life, how He's changed us. We're so thankful He's always coming through for us. Man, we're so thankful that 2020 is the best year of our life. Glory be to God. We're expecting great things to happen. We're expecting to see Jesus do things that we ain't never seen Him do before. We're expecting legs to grow out, arms to grow out, fingers, toes, people to get brand new body parts. Hallelujah. We have made up a decision in our life that we are going to follow Jesus, and we're going to keep our eyes on Him, and we're going to keep our eyes on Him crucified so we can walk in love every day with people. Man, we love y'all so much. So thankful for y'all. We're thankful for everything you do for True Christian Fellowship. Thankful for everything you do for Pastor Robert, Miss Yvette. Man, we just love y'all so much. Man, I'm so excited. We're going to be talking about the doctrine of devils again, part three. We're going to be, you know, we've already went over really what the doctrine of devils is in parts one and two. But this is going to finish out the chapter here in 1 Timothy chapter 4. It's still, you know, talking about doctrine of devils and things. But this more or less is going to be talking about the conduct of God's servants. And see, we have to really follow the conduct of God's servants, because if we don't walk in the conduct that He's called us to, which is pure and holy before Him, then people are not going to look to us and follow us if our conduct ain't holy. Peter said that our conduct should be holy. And conduct don't just mean your speech, it means the way you act also. Praise God. So we got to learn to walk in holiness in everything that we do, so people see that we're holy. Remember when Peter and them, the man at the gate called Beautiful, when they raised him up, they said, "Don't look on us as if our holiness did this, but it's done through the power of the name of Jesus Christ." But it's amazing to me, I've always thought that Peter said, "Don't look at our holiness." So holiness should be something people can see in mine and your life. Hallelujah. So we got to ask the Holy Ghost every day how to teach us to walk in holiness before God, before Jesus, so that we can, you know, see His power operating every day in our life. Hallelujah. Well, let's go to 1 Timothy chapter 4, and we're going to start with verse 8 here. It says, "For bodily exercise profiteth little." See, it don't say that bodily exercise don't profit at all. It said it profits little. It profits little compared to what we can do spiritually. But godliness is profitable unto all things. See, when we're following Jesus and following righteousness and following fellowship with the Holy Ghost and praying and reading our Bible and going to church and being a giver into the kingdom of God, all that produces in the kingdom is profitable. Man, the angels are taking, they're taking dictate of your life, of what you've done in your life. There's books in heaven wrote about me and you. Books are wrote about us. And I pray every book wrote about me in heaven comes to pass in my life. Amen. Everything God had planned for me, like in Jeremiah 29:11, all His plans for me is to prosper. His plans for me to be success. Man, I want all them books to come to pass in my life as I follow Him and do what He says. But for godliness profitable to all things, having promise of life that now is and of that which is to come. This is a faithful saying and worthy of all exception. Amen. So we got to learn that to follow Jesus and do what He says. It is a faithful saying to do that and to follow the Master. Now, I like the Passion Bible says, it says, "For athletic training only benefits you for a short season." Y'all know, man, when athletic training, when you're living this world, you like if you play basketball, football, that there's a time frame where you're at your peak. You might be like, I watched a show the other day about Dr. J. You know, I like Dr. J basketball, and he can still dunk a basketball at 60, y'all. But he can't go out there and tear up those young bucks, you know, on the basketball field now like he could back then. He's 60 now. So all this athletic training, it only benefits you for a short season, because the body is decaying every day. You know, and I speak over my body that I'm going to live healthy and whole until Jesus comes and gets me, praise God. And you have to do that. You have to speak to your body. I command my heart to beat with the rhythm of life. Speak to your body. It says, but righteousness brings lasting benefit in everything, for righteousness contains the promise of life for time and eternity. See, righteousness, being right standing with God, that's for eternity. You got to perfect that in godliness. How do you do that? By hearing what Jesus said and doing it. That's how you perfect righteousness in your life, right standing with God, is by hearing what the Master taught, said, and did, and obeying it. Hallelujah. Faithfulness, faithful is the word, and everyone should accept him. Faithful is the word, and everyone should accept him. Who? Jesus, the Messiah, the Christ, what he taught, what he said, and what he did. In the New International Version, it says, for physical training is of some value. So there is some value in it. We're not saying there's no value in physical training. We're saying it don't compare to godly training. It only lasts for a little while, but godliness has value for all things, holding promise for both the present life and the life to come. See, this physical training is just for this life. It ain't got nothing to do with the next life. But godly training is for this life and the life to come. Amen. When you follow Jesus now, it ain't just for now. It's for an eternity, for the life to come. It says, verse 9, this is a trustworthy saying that deserves full acceptance. That's a trustworthy saying that fully you should accept, that physical training is just for this lifetime, but godly training is for this lifetime and for the life to come. Hallelujah. In the Amplified Version, is for physical training is of some value, useful for a little, but godliness, spiritual training, is useful and of value in everything, in every way, for it holds promise for the present life and also the life that's to come. Verse 9 said, this saying is reliable and worthy of complete acceptance by everybody. Man, when it says, that means you have to accept this if you're going to follow Jesus, because it's worthy of full acceptance by everybody. Praise God. It's a full acceptance by everybody. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Where am I at? The Message Bible? All right, the Message Bible. And we did read, I think we read 7 or 8 last time. I can't remember. But we're going to read it again. It says, exercise daily in God. Exercise daily in God. No spiritual flabbiness, please. Workouts in the gymnasium are useful, but discipline in God is far more so, making you fit both today and forever. Today and forever. You can count on this. Take it to heart. Amen. Take it to heart. So when you work out this in the spiritual aspect, and you're doing this in godliness, you're working out in God, people can see you changing, your very conduct change, where you walk in holiness towards people. How do you walk in holiness towards people? Well, when they see you living in holiness, it shows them there is a way, even in this world today, that people can live in holiness before God, showing them there is a way you can live deeper in Him, to produce results in this earthly realm, because you've tapped into the heavenly realm by living holy before a holy God. Remember, he said, be holy for I'm holy. He's calling us to a level of discipline in him that we do what he says, and when we do what the Spirit says, what he leads us to do, we walk in holiness towards God. And remember, without holiness and peace with all men, no one is going to see our Father God. So you got to walk in holiness if you're going to go to heaven and spend an eternity with Him. I do too. Praise God. So we got to learn to follow Him and do what He says so we can walk in this holiness that He's talking about. Amen. You can count on this. Take it to heart. It says, this is why we've thrown ourselves into this venture so totally. We're banking on the living God, Savior of all men and women, especially believers. Man, we're banking on this. This is truth. That this is what is God. God's going to take us further and further in Him because we're following what His Word said. Verse 10 in the passage says, "For the sake of this ministry, we told tirelessly and criticized continually, simply because our hope is in the living God. He is the wonderful life giver of all the children of men, and even more of those who believe." Man, our whole life in the church, in the ministry, is for God. It's for Him, man. This is all about Him. Not about us, but all about Him. We want to do what He's saying, what He taught. We want all glory to go to Him, and we don't want the glory to come to us. We want this view that this what we're doing is for not just this world, but the world to come. Rewards are coming by us living for Jesus and living holy before God and influencing people's life to follow Jesus. Rewards are coming to us. Get ready, man. Do what the Master called you to do so you can bring people to Jesus. In the Amplified, it said, with a view to this, we toil and strive, yes, and suffer reproach, because we have fixed our hope on the living God. Man, my hope is fixed on the Master, on the living God, that He's going to do exactly what He called me, told me He was going to do, and I'm going to see the salvation of the Lord come to pass in my life. That's why I always say my whole family is going to serve the Lord. He promised me and my household, my children are going to serve the Lord. They're going to follow Him and do exactly what He tells them to do. Amen. I just believe that. Because we have fixed our hope on the living God, who is the Savior, Preserver, Maintainer, Deliverer of all man. And you want to meet this Jesus I'm talking about? Start serving Him and doing what He says. You'll see Him in your life as a preserver, a maintainer, a deliverer in every circumstance me and you face. He will deliver you out of that all. These doctrinal devils we've been talking about for a couple of weeks now, if you'll turn away from them and turn away from seducing spirits and repent and turn back to the cross and the living God, this Jesus Christ I'm talking about, this maintainer, He will deliver you from that. Hallelujah. He will deliver you from you and what you think should happen, and He will show you what He wants to happen. Hey, and praise God. We got to turn to Him. Why? He's the maintainer, preserver, and deliverer of all men. Trust in. Why? Trust in Him. Why? Rely on and adhere to Him. Who? Those who believe. Those who believe, who especially believe in Him, they got to learn to trust and rely on, adhere to Him. Like you're hooked up to a life support system that you can't make it without Him. Hallelujah. Hook up to Jesus. Do what the Master's called you to do. Suffer for His kingdom. Suffer for the kingdom of the living God. Amen. And you will be paid back. Your reward will be wonderful. Your reward will be great. Hallelujah. The NIV version, hallelujah, verse 10 says, that is why we labor and strive. Man, why are you laboring and striving for the kingdom? I think we get off track sometime. When if we would just make ourselves labor and strive to be godly before Him and to do what He says and get all this fleshy stuff out of our mind, wanting to preserve our body for fleshly things on this earth. No, you preserve your body. That's fine to ask the Lord to make you healthy and you're going to live to 120 or till you're satisfied. But your mind and focus and spirit is going to be focused on this afterlife, that you're going to do what He said to do here, and that's going to go out through eternity. That's what it is, following God and doing what God says. Amen. We put our hope in a living God who is the Savior of all people, especially of those who believe. Man, especially of those who believe. It don't really mean nothing if you don't believe, rely on, cling to, and trust in Him. Some people talk about God, y'all, but their heart is far from Him. They're going to split hell wide open. They're not going to heaven to live in eternity with the Master, Savior, Jesus Christ, the King of kings and Lord of lords. They're focused on the things of this world. They're not focused on the things of another world, of the world that is to come. No, they're focused on this world and what they can get out of this world and what they can do in this world and how they can bring people to know Jesus, you know, here, and then they don't even live for Him. And I've had people, you know, that I've known that's been in the kingdom of the living God, you know, doing things for Him, walking according to His what they thought was His Word, and, you know, saying they live for Him and all this, and they don't even live for Him. They just using the gospel of Jesus Christ for filthy lucre to get paid. you know, this singer, you know, he got right before he died, but he used to talk about how they'd go out and sing the gospel, you know, quartet, they traveled all over, and how they would just, they would drink and just laugh at people for crying and coming in conviction of the songs they sang about Jesus. Well, thank God he got right before he left here, but I wonder if the other three did. You can have preachers out there preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, but they're not living that themselves, and they're not going to heaven when they die, and they're just out there just building their own kingdom. No, you got to build his kingdom. It's all about him, not me and you. It's about the Master Jesus Christ and him crucified. That's what we need to be teaching people. In the verse 11 in the King James says, these things command and teach. Man, command and teach the people what we've been talking about in these first 10 verses. Tell them to stay away from seducing spirits. Stay away from doctrine of devils. Get in a church that's teaching Jesus, that's teaching about sin, that's teaching to repent and turn back to God, that's teaching about the love of God and how to forgive people and walk in love towards people. Man, get in a church that's teaching that. It's okay to tell people they can be rich and all this stuff, and we believe people should be healthy, they should be wealthy, but we believe they should walk in love to obtain that. Hallelujah. You got to walk in love. And then Paul, he's talking to Timothy here, he said, let no man despise your youth, but be an example of the believers. Y'all, we got to be an example to believers around us. How do we do that? In word, in conversation, in charity, in spirit, in faith, and in purity. How long did, till I come, give attendance to the reading, to the exhortation, to doctrine. Neglect not the gift that is in thee. Man, some of y'all got gifts in y'all, and y'all just let them die and go dormant. Man, you need to stir them gifts up and be used. Let them be used. And neglect not that gift that's in thee, which was given to thee by prophecy with the laying on of hands. Hallelujah. Meditate upon these things. Give thyself wholly to them, that thy profiting may appear to all. Take heed unto thee and unto the doctrine. Continue with them, for in doing this thou shalt save both save thyself and them that hear thee. Man, that's why you have to give yourself to God and do what God's called you to do, because by doing this, you're going to save people. Not just you, but you're going to save the people that listen to you, that hear you. Hallelujah. And the NIV version of this part of Scripture, verse 11, says, command and teach these things. Command and teach these things. Don't let anyone look down on you because of how young you are. Man, I've always said that my whole life. I don't let people look down on me because of how young I am. When I was preaching in my 20s and 30s and 40s, the older people, I wouldn't let them look down on me because I was young. Now I'm 57, be 58 in January. I ain't letting the ones that are 60, 70, 80 look down on me, because I'm going to preach the word of the living God, the truth that he spoke to Jesus, and Jesus spoke to us. Jesus' doctrine, the story that came from the lips of Messiah himself. So I'm not going to let people look down on me because I have a revelation that God's given me through the Holy Spirit about following Jesus and doing what he said and not following everybody else unless they're following Christ. Man, I'm not going to let them talk down on me because of that. The Bible says, if you love the world, you the love of the Father squeezed out of you. I'm not going to let you look down on me because I believe that and it's in the Word and I didn't speak it. Jesus did through John. Man, come on now. Follow Jesus and do what he says. Hallelujah. But he says for me to set an example for the believers in speech, conduct, love, faith, and purity. Until I come, devote yourself to the public reading of Scripture. Man, we need to be, the word needs to go forth. Out of my mouth and your mouth. You need to be telling people at your workplace, the words of Jesus need to be coming out of your mouth, publicly telling people about Jesus. Amen. To preaching and teaching, telling people, teaching, preaching, tell them about, do not neglect your gift, which was given to you through prophecy when the body of elders laid their hands on you. Be diligent in these matters. He's talking to Timothy, but I'm relating that to me. I'm going to be diligent in these matters, giving myself wholly to them so that everyone may see my progress in following him. Watch your life, my life, and doctrine closely. Preserve it in them, because if you do, you will save both yourself and your hearers. Man, that's what I strive to do is the message I'm preaching, I'm praying it's saving me and the ones that hear me preach the message of Jesus Christ, the one God has come and called and set forth in him. Amen? Man, I'm going to preach what the Master said, what he taught, what he did. I want to do let people see him in me. Glory to God. Now, the Amplified Version, man, we know in verse 11, continue to command these things and to teach them. Let no one despise or think less of you because of your youth. you're younger than them is the way I look at it. But be an example, a pattern for the believers in speech and conduct, love, faith, and impurity. Till I come, devote yourself to public and private reading, to exhortation, preaching, and personal appeals, and to teaching and instilling doctrine. Do not neglect the gift that's within you. I'm not going to neglect the gifts that are within me. Why? Because he wants to use this gift to bless people around me, and he wants to use the gifts in you to bless people around you. Stir up those gifts that within you. Hallelujah. They were directly imparted to me by the Holy Spirit, by prophetic utterance of the elders, laid their hands upon me at their ordination. Practice and cultivate and meditate on these duties. Throw yourself wholly into them as your ministry, so that your progress may be evident to everybody. Man, like let people see how much you've grown in the Lord. I've grown spiritually in the Lord. I've grown in His Word. I've grown in the ministry of the doctrine of Jesus Christ Himself. I've grown. People have to see that in me and you, that we've grown in the things of God. Then verse 16 says, look well at yourself, to your own personality, and to your own teaching. Preserve in these things. Hold to them. For by so doing so, you save both yourself and those that hear you. Ain't it amazing? He's telling us here that we're going to save people that hear us. He wants us, by what our teaching of the Word is, and by living holy in front of people, people are going to see Jesus in us, and it's going to want them to come to know Jesus Christ as their Savior and to follow Him and do what He says. Hallelujah, man. This Word is just so awesome. And the Message Bible says, get the Word out, teach all these things. Get the Word out, teach all these things. What? That doctrines of devils are in church, seducing spirits are in church. They're teaching people not to marry. They're teaching people to eat just certain things. Instead of preaching them the whole Word, they're teaching people that body exercise is so important, but we know it does import a little, but it don't even compare to godly exercise, because that's for this life and for the life to come. So he wants us to teach and get this stuff out. Teach all these things. Tell people you got to follow Jesus and do what he's saying. You got to cultivate the gifts within you. You got to let the Holy Ghost use you to bring people to Jesus. And then he said, don't let anybody put you down because you're young. Teach believers with your life. How do you teach them with your life? By what? By the Word, your Word. By your demeanor, by your love for people, by your faith in Jesus, by your integrity, that what you say you'll do. You don't just need to be a person that says, oh, I'll do this and never do it. When I'm late for doctor's appointments or anything, I mean, talking about if I'm a minute or two late, I call them and let them know, hey, I'm running late. You shock some of them. Why? They ain't used to that. They're used to people showing up 30 minutes, an hour late, and then thinking it's your fault because they were late. No, he wants to be people of integrity. If I tell you I'm going to be there, I need to be there. Or I need to let you know that something happened, something come up, and I'm not going to make it at that time. But let your word be integrity, that when you tell people something, they believe you. And don't say, they don't think, oh, well, we'll see what happens. Hello. The other day I had an appointment at 10 o'clock and it was 9:55 and it said I'd be there at 10:01. So I called him. I said, it says I'm going to be there a minute late. So I was just letting you know that I'm on my way. Well, come to find out I got there a minute early because sometimes them things change. But I was going to be, my word was going to be that what I said I was going to do. The integrity of the word that comes out of my mouth, people need to believe. The same with you. People need to believe what you say. Hallelujah. They need to believe you if you tell them something. Stay at your post reading scripture, giving counsel, teaching. See, to be able to give counsel and teaching, you need to be staying at your post reading the scripture, studying the scripture, so you know how to counsel and what advice to give. Hello. He didn't tell you, man, make sure you stay up to date with the news and up to date with everything that's going on in social media so that you can be able to counsel and teach people. No, he said stay at your post reading scripture, learning, teaching yourself what the master taught, said and did, so you can teach people and counsel them when they need it. And then that spiritual gift of ministry you were given when the elders laid their hands on you when they prayed, keep that dusted off and in use. No, you got to stay at it. You got to stay at it. Amen. You got to preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. And you got to, if God's called you to preach, preach. If he's called you to help, help. If he called you to pray for the pastor, pray for the pastor. If he called you in intercessory prayer, intercede in prayer. If he's called you to work in the church, work. If he's called you to make money for the church, make all you can and always have a heart to give to the kingdom. Hallelujah. Always have a heart to give to the kingdom. Verse 15 says, cultivate these things. Immerse yourself in them. Just immerse yourself in the things of God so that people can see your life as you're living holy before Him. Why? The people will see you mature right before their eyes. People will see you mature right before their eyes. Keep a firm grasp on both your character and your teaching. Man, character is important that you live in front of people holy before God and people. Don't be diverted. Just keep at it. Man, over these past 19 years of True Christian Fellowship, I could have easily been diverted if I'd have got my eyes on people and what they wanted to happen at True Christian Fellowship. We would have bought some land and built a church in the beginning, then they left, we'd have lost it. But God's kept us in Him to where we have a church. We don't have a church building, but we're in a church. It's pretty nice. I mean, we've kept it up. It's excellent as far as what the part that we can do. And He's paid for it. He's took care of it. Amen. And He's been there with us. He's showed us what to do through everything. And now we're believing He's going to bring about some land, or He's going to bring about, a church building, or something's going to happen. We're going to move out. But it's all going to be about Him. If He tells us to stay where we'll stay. And we will be happy that what He said is exactly what needs to happen in these last days. We're not going to get diverted. We're going to keep at it. Hallelujah. Even though a lot of people wish we'd close down. I don't understand people that get offended and leave a church and then want that church to close down. The church I left, back when we started the church, some things happened that caused me to have to leave. Hello. I talked to the pastor, not to anybody else, about what was going on and what happened. Come on now. It wasn't no sense in tearing the church down. But people left and wanted that church to close down. And I didn't want the church to close down. I wanted them to accomplish what the Lord had called them to do. And I still pray that for that church, that God uses them to accomplish what God's called them to do, and He uses Pastor Robert and True Christian Fellowship to accomplish what He's called us to do. Amen? Keep at it. Both you and those who hear you will experience salvation. Man, we need to learn to follow Jesus and do what He said in every situation so that when people see us, they see that we're following Him and doing what He said. Amen? I want to look at one more version here, and if I can find it, I'm going to read from it. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let me see here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Sometimes it's hard to find them I got my phone pulled out here. I'm trying to find it here. It may not be in here. I think it is. Let me find it here. I love y'all. Man, I hope y'all love me. I hope y'all have enjoyed this series here. Praise God. Here we go. Here it is. It was just a different version of what it's saying. It's in the easy read version. I like this one. It's in verse 11. It says, command and teach these things. You are young, but don't let anyone treat you as if you are not important. Be an example to show the believers how they should live. Man, you everybody in the body of Christ should have somebody under them that's looking to their life, and your life should be showing that person how to live. Amen. Show them by what you say and by the way you live and by your love and your faith and by your pure life. Continue to read the scriptures to the people. There should be somebody in your life that you're always telling about the scriptures, something about the scriptures, and reading them scriptures them so they can see, and you encourage them through these scriptures and teach them, and do this until Jesus comes. Remember to use the gift that God and the Holy Ghost has put within you, which was given to you when you were prophesied over, when the Holy Ghost said He was going to use you to do things in the body of Christ. Continue to do these things. Continue. Give your life doing them. Then everyone can see that your work is progressing. Man, let people see that you're going up higher and higher in the Lord Jesus. Higher and higher in Him. Don't get away from Him and doing the things you want to do and letting doctrines of devils and seducing the spirits get you off track. No, stay close to Him and do what He's told you to do. Be careful in your life and in your teaching. When that's talking about be careful, it's not talking about take care. Because when people tell me to take care, I say, no, Jesus said take care for nothing, so I can't take care. But this is talking about in the ministry and in studying the Word and the doctrine you're teaching. Be careful in that. Be careful in your teaching and your life that you are teaching what the Master taught, said, and did, the message that came from His lips. Amen. Continue to live and teach rightly. How do you do that? By following Jesus. Then you will save yourself and those who listen to your teaching. That's my greatest desire, that people that listen to me teach the Word of God, it would cause them to be convicted to live for Jesus. That's why I'm always on you about you got to go to church if you're going to be a follower of Jesus. You got to be a tither and giver if you're going to be a follower of Jesus. You got to read your Bible every day and pray every day and be submitted to the authority in your life if you're going to be a follower of Jesus. And guess what, y'all? If you ain't a follower of Jesus, you ain't going to go to heaven. And that's just my belief. I believe you got to follow Him and you got to be holy, because He said, be holy for I'm holy. I believe He says, straight the way is narrow the gate, few there be that find it. A lot of people go to church, but everybody ain't found the way to Jesus. Because on that way, it's Him. It's in Him. That's how you find it, is in Him. Amen. That's why it's a straight and narrow way, because you're in Him. There ain't nobody else on that road but Him and those that are in Him. And when He comes back, when the rapture happened, He's coming back for Himself, because He's the head and you're the body and I'm the body. So if you're in Him, He's coming back for you, His body. Make sure you're walking in holiness before it. Make sure you're teaching these things to people. But make sure you're obeying Him and doing what He's saying. Man, I love y'all so much. I've really enjoyed this. I've really enjoyed this teaching. Praise God. And I'm just thankful the Lord's going to show us exactly what to do in everything that we do. And we have purpose in our heart. We're going to follow Him and we're going to love Him because He first loved us. And we'll see y'all Sunday at 10 a.m. Well, we're so thankful. Man, it is altar call time. Praise God. So if you're here today, you know, if you listen to the message today, and we're just so thankful that you joined in with us today. And if you need to give your whole life to Jesus right now, we want you to repeat after me. Say, Father, I come to You today. I believe Your Word. I've been convicted today of sin in my life. Lord, I thank You for rescuing me from my sins. I thank You for shedding Your blood and presenting an offering to the Father that took away all my sin. Now, Father, I believe right now in Jesus. Jesus, I confess You as my Lord. Father, I believe in my heart that You raised Jesus from the dead. And according to Your Word right now, I'm born again. Now, Father, I've believed in Him. I'm relying on, clinging to, and trusting in Him. Now, Father, make me a disciple. Show me Jesus' doctrine. And let someone put me under someone that'll teach me how to follow His doctrine and live in accordance with it. If you don't have a church home, make your church home True Christian Fellowship and come and let Pastor Robert be over you in the Lord. And I'll teach you how to follow Jesus through the teachings of Christ. Amen. Now, if you've given your whole life to Jesus, man, just send me if you got my phone number, send me a text. If you don't, then send me an email. Just please take the time and send me an email at godisslapawesome@bellsouth.net. So I can give a praise report on the air of what God's did in your life. Amen. And that goes for all y'all watching that's in the church and God's doing things for you. I've been telling you now to send me praise reports to my email address or text me. And if you got one and ain't done it, then people are missing out on hearing your report, because the Bible says, make your deeds known among the people. So if He's done anything for you, you need to let me know through email or through a text, so I can do it on the next service and say, man, we just want to praise God for God doing this in so-and-so's life. Amen? Hey, we're so thankful. And Lord, right now we're believing that Your Word says we can lay hands on the sick and they'll recover. We can send Your Word and people can get healed. So right now, if there's any problem in your body, the doctors gave you a bad report, no matter what it is, right now I ask you to put your hand on that. I'm going to stretch forth my hand. I'm believing right now in Jesus' name. The anointing is flowing through this. coming into you wherever your hand is, and we're driving out that demonic force that's trying to attack itself to your body, and you're going to walk totally healthy, healed, and whole. You're a healed woman in a healthy body. You're a healed man in a healthy body. Now just receive that and receive it with thanksgiving and praise God that you've been delivered from whatever that circumstance is. Amen. And just let him know how thankful you are that you're walking in victory in Jesus. Amen. And we're just so thankful for y'all. We can't wait to see y'all again. And we love y'all so much. And we praise God for you. We praise God for you. We're so thankful for you. Hallelujah. And don't forget, if you're doing your offering by mail, don't forget to send it. If you're doing it by the church, drop it off, put it in the slot. And we're so thankful for y'all, your faithfulness. And we praise God for you. And we thank God for you. Amen. And we thank God for more coming. In Jesus' name, amen.